Hello and welcome to this session on how to create a Selenium Java framework from scratch. I'm Raghav and today we are going to learn how to create our first Selenium test. So we will see how to create a Selenium test in Java and we will run and validate our test. And towards the end, we will also look at some useful tips. So you can follow this session on Windows as well as Mac operating system. And as always, we are going to go very basic step by step. So let's get started. And step number one is we have to create a Java class. So let me go to my Eclipse and I'm going to this framework, this project that we have been creating in our earlier sessions. So you can also watch the earlier session if you have not yet created this project. And here in this project, we have created a class browser test and we have already learned how to add Selenium libraries and how to run our test on multiple browsers like Firefox, Chrome, and Internet Explorer. So now what I'm going to do is I can create a new class here. So I can do a right click on the package and then go to new and select class from here. Now what I want to do now is I want to create this new class in a new package. So what I will do is I will do a right click and say new. And I will select package first and you can give any name. I am giving the name as test and say finish. And now you can see this test package is created and this is empty. So now I will do a right click on this package and say new and say class. And here I can give any name. So I will say this is test one. Now you should give some meaningful names which can show you what exactly the test is for. So for example, I can also say this is for underscore Google search. Okay, so I'm going to create a test that will go to Google and do a search. So I'm just saying test one Google search. And here you can keep other things by default. And here you can select this public static void main so that it will create a main method for you. But I will also show you how to create this. So I will just say finish now. And you can see the class is here. And now I will create a main method. I will say main and press control spacebar on my keyboard and it will give me this auto suggestion. I will select this one. So this is the main method which is the starting point for any Java program. And in the earlier session, we had created all our code inside the main method. But now I'm going to create a new function and I will say public static void and let me name it as Google search and brackets and curly braces and enter, and this is my function. So here I will start creating my test. Okay, so we have done step one. Step two is add code to open browser. So as we have already learned, I will first have to initialize driver. So I will say web driver equals to new and let me go to Chrome driver. So I will say Chrome and control spacebar. I will select this option. Okay, so it will automatically import this dependencies here. So you can see it has imported and web driver has some issue. So if I hover over this, it will show me that you have to use some other type. So I am changing it to web driver, which is from org openqa selenium. So let me do it again. This is the one I want to use. Okay, so W and D are capital here. And here I can now here we also have to set the path for Chrome driver executable, which is here, and we have already added it earlier. So you can see this is here. I have to add its path. So for that I will say system.getProperty, and all these things we have already learned earlier. So this should be very easy for you. This should be set property, right? So system.setProperty, and here I have to say webdriver.chrome.driver, and here I have to give the location of my Chrome driver exe, which we have already added here in the earlier session. Now I'm going to make use of the code from the earlier session, and you can see this was the code. So I will just copy it from here and save it here in place of this statement. So system.set property web driver, sorry, this is for Geeko driver. I have to copy for the Chrome driver. So I can actually use Firefox as well, but let me use Chrome this time. Yeah, this is the statement. I will copy it from here and replace this statement here. And also, do you see we are getting a red underline on the project path, because in this particular function and class we have not yet defined project path. So again, let me go back and get the code of project path as well. And project path is, we have taken the path of this framework so that I do not have to give the entire location. So here I will again give the same thing. So project path is system.getProperty user dir. So our project location will be stored here, and then we are saying the location of Chrome driver is project path, and then go to the rest of the location, which is drivers here, Chrome driver this folder, and Chrome driver.exe this folder. Okay, so now we are done with our Chrome driver setup, and the first step will be we have to go to google.com. okay, so let me go to my browser, and if I go to google.com, so you can see this is https://google.com. so I will say here, and double forward slashes here are for comments, and you can also use multi-line comments. You can say forward slash star and press enter, and here you can give anything. So you can write any comment, and comments are not processed during execution. So this is very useful for easy understanding of the code. So always comment your code. So on each line or block or section, always have the comments to say what exactly this particular section is doing. So here I will say driver dot get, and here I have to say https://google.com. okay, and then next step is we have to enter text in search text box. Okay, so here is the search text box, and here we have to enter something. So we have already seen in our earlier session how to identify and find locators. So here I can do right click and go to inspect, and here you can see this is the section for the search text box, and we have the ID here, we have the name here. So we have already seen some tools as well, like CrowPath is there, and then we have Escri, and then other tools that we can use. So this time I'm just going to use this name, which is Q, right? So name is Q here. So I will say here driver dot find element, and you are getting this auto suggestion. I will select this by dot name. And just in case this is new to you, please watch the earlier session where I have covered this find element function, and by the name Q, and then we have to dot send keys. So I can type anything. Let me say automation step by step. I'm just typing this here. Okay, and then we have to, next step is click on search button. So I will say driver dot again find element, and here we have to find this Google search. I have to click on here. So I will again inspect, and let us see the properties. So here again we have name available, which is btnk. Let me use that. So I will say again find element by dot name, and the name is btnk, and here the action is dot click. So we have to click. So you can see all this Selenium actions are here. I will say click, and then next step is we have to close browser. So I will just say driver dot close. Okay, so this is done, and now I can also at the end print something out on this console. So I will say SYSO, press control spacebar on my keyboard. I will get this auto suggestion. I will select this one, and here I am just printing test completed successfully. Okay, and I will save this by pressing control S, And here now I can run this. So let us see if this will run. So this will actually not run. Let me just show you. If I do a right click and say run as, and Java application, and if you see the console here, let me show you the console. So here you can see nothing is running. Why? Because our start is the main method. For any Java program, start is from the main method, and in the main method we are not doing actually anything. So we have to call our function here. So I will just say Google search. So this is the function that I will call here, and now I can do right click, run as Java application, and let us see. So now it opens a Chrome browser, types automation step by step, and it actually did not click on the search button. So if I go back and see the console, so it is finding difficult to find the search button. Okay, so see name btnk, so element, this is not able to find this. Okay, so the reason can be when you are entering something here, so it is actually doing this or giving this auto suggestion box, and the search button is hidden. So as a workaround, what we can do here is, instead of hitting the search button, we can also hit enter key on the keyboard. And for that, what we can do is, let me use the same statement up till here, which is finding of the element, and then we have a function called we have keys. Okay, so if I have to send keyboard keys, I will say keys dot, and then I think return is for enter. Yes, return is here, so you can see return. So keys is again a class which helps us to press keyboard keys. And whenever you face these kind of issues and you want to find out, just go to Google, and let us say I'm going to Google, and I will say Selenium how to press enter key, and hit enter, and you will find a lot of suggestions. I am going to the first Stack Overflow article, and here you can see it is giving us this solution. So you have to use send keys and keys, then the name is returned. So I am using the same thing, so I will just comment this out, okay, and save it, and let me run this again. So here, run as Java application, goes to a Chrome browser, types in, hits enter, and closes. So this was very quick, and you can also see it has written here, test completed successfully. So our test was completed. Now what I have shown you is a very crude way of writing a test. This is still a Selenium test, but we are not actually following the framework principles, because in a framework things should be modular, it should be organized, then we should also have results and all other things. But that is something exactly we are going to learn in the next episode. This was a very quick session just to show you how you can create test scripts in Selenium. This is actually not a very good framework design. As of now, we have not actually started creating a good framework, but we have just started understanding the basic concepts. And this is very useful, because once your basic concepts are clear, it will be very useful when we start inputting and when we start applying all the framework creation techniques. So if you look at our steps, we have already added open browser, we have added code to browse for browser actions, we have closed the browser, and we have also ran our test and validated it. So some useful tips. So as I have also discussed in earlier sessions, you can check for your selected locators on different browsers. For example, we selected two locators here. One was for text box and then for Google search. You can always verify that these locators work fine and are available on different browsers, whatever is in scope for your testing. And then you can also take helps of some tools that we have seen in the last session. So there are some tools which help you in generating the xpaths. And then whenever you face any error or any issue, always check the logs and then copy your error on Google and search. So whenever you face an issue, like whenever in this session we faced an issue, you can always check your console where you will get the logs. Just copy it, go to Google and paste it there and search for solutions, and you will always get a lot of options there. So this is something you will this will help you throughout your career whenever you are working with Selenium or any tool. So let's do a very quick recap. Today we learned how to create a test in Selenium and we ran and validated it. I hope this session was very useful. If you like this session, please hit the like button and share with others so that it can help everyone. And if you have not yet subscribed to this channel, please hit the subscribe button and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you can receive notifications on all the new videos that I will add. So I hope this all was very useful. I will meet you in the next episode. Thank you for watching.